reason I say that, Jesus is the answer for the world today. Above him there's no other, cause Jesus is the way.
Hi, I'm Kim Fields. I play Tootie on The Facts of Life. You know, as young people, we're always searching for answers, and we tend to find them in the wrong places or in the wrong things. Well, here's the answer that I found is just great. Jesus is the answer. And you can watch a program called Jesus is the Answer nightly on your local cable station with a dynamic young preacher by the name of Ernest Johnson. So remember, that's Jesus is the Answer nightly on your local cable network.
Praise the Lord, and welcome to another anointed broadcast of Jesus is the Answer. This is Elder Ernest Johnson coming your way one more time, and I thank the Lord Jesus Christ for the opportunity to come into your homes. I thank God that drug addicts are being delivered. Amen. Homosexuals are being made straight. Those that are bound by depression, God is setting them free. And I thank God for the opportunity one more time to be able to come into your home, to pray with you, to encourage you, to share the Word of God with you. Amen. Tonight, we're going to take a cruise around the San Pedro Harbor. Yes, my brothers and sisters, this is a cruise, amen, where we're going to get together and lift up the precious name of Jesus Christ. Amen. There's so many celebrities in the gospel that will be here tonight lifting up the name of Jesus Christ. We're going on the K-Max cruise. Hallelujah. That's K-M-N-A-X 107.1 on the FM dial. Reginald Utley will be on the show today. Linda Johnson Hayes, who is the general manager, will be on the broadcast today. And many people that are lining up, even as I speak, for this cruise right now. We're going to have a time in Jesus Christ. We want you to buckle your seat belts and come on, amen, as we go out on the waters that God created. Hallelujah. We're going to sail out there, and this is a dinner cruise, and we're going to have a time in Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. Jesus is the Answer is teaming up with K-Max, LA's number one gospel station. So buckle your seats, won't you? But the first thing we're going to do, we got to pray. Amen. We want to have a safe trip. We want to have a blessed trip, and we want you to just come on along with us. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, we thank you, Lord, as we take this cruise right now. We ask you, Lord, to save souls. We ask you to minister to those that are watching by way of television right now. Minister to, Lord, to all of those that will be a part of this broadcast. Hallelujah. Bless the entertainment, Lord. Hallelujah. Bless the dinner, Lord, in Jesus' name, and encourage those viewers that are watching right now in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Listen, come on. Time to go on the cruise.
Thank you.
mainstream of gospel music, what is the advantage of doing gospel music as opposed to secular from your standpoint?
Well, I've never had any experience doing secular music, but the peace of mind that I get from working for the Lord is every advantage that could possibly be. When you realize that when you are working for the Master and that's going to be, your reward is going to be eternal life, well, common sense tells you to go with eternal life rather than hell and damnation. And I'm delighted, however, that I am able to be working in gospel music, a music that I love. We've been doing the show on BET for the past 10 years, and it brings me to people like you and other people across the world. So I enjoy that.
In dealing with most of the gospel artists that you deal with in doing the Bobby Jones Gospel Hour, do you find that most of them really have a deep spiritual background?
Yes, I do. And I do that from observing their performance and what they have to say and how they say it, but I don't make judgments. I think the Lord admonishes us about that. So I do try to find out what their particular ministry is all about, what is their main focus and purpose with the ministry, and then from that point we go forth. But I always alleviate the area of judgment because we aren't supposed to do that, but I do make close observations.
Okay. What impact does the Bobby Jones Gospel Hour have for new artists, and what opportunities do you provide for them?
Well, Mr. Johnson, at this point, we have the only network black gospel show in the world. And anyone who's trying to get their product out there naturally want to get to the world. And fortunately, the Black Entertainment Television Network, Acts Christian Television, the American Christian Television Network, and Vision are the three major networks that I'm on in America, provide that conduit. We have over, with those three networks, over 50 million subscribers. And then, of course, in other countries, we have far more than that, like Nigeria and Zimbabwe. So I think it would provide an excellent platform for someone to be able to minister to people, share with them what the Lord has done for them and what the Lord can do for them through their music.
What do you envision for the future of gospel music as a general statement, and what is your vision for your show and for gospel music?
Well, I don't think gospel music is going to go where we want it to go in terms of getting the glitzy lights and things of that nature, because I don't think it's supposed to be there. I do, however, feel that the word is going to be heard by every man, woman, boy, and girl throughout this world, but it won't take the same conduit that secular music has taken, and thank God for that. I think there are a lot of gospel artists who may think that that is a way to go. To get to the masses is one thing, but how you get there is another. I envision that once we people who love gospel music decide to unite our efforts and uplift the kingdom of the Lord, I think the Lord will bless that music to put it wherever He wants it to go, through us. And until we understand that principle, then I think we're going to be still quagmired in our relationships and abilities to get that music to the masses of people. I think gospel music is an answer in this world today. It always has been, but now in this high world of technology, I think it can be a very resourceful means for pastors and for just regular people who are trying to find some healing and some answers to some of the problems that we're concerned with today. Now, we must remind ourselves that we've always had concerns. It doesn't matter whether it was 1930, 40, 50, or 1990. The concerns are just different, and we have to place those concerns in perspective as to what we're doing today. So I think gospel music, as will the rest of the work of the Lord, will serve as a conduit to reach people, to help to bring people to Christ.
Are you glad to be on the K-Max cruise tonight?
I'm excited about being here. I made a special effort to come out here. I was booked in the Bronx, New York tonight, and the K-Max people called and pleaded with me and told me they would really like for me to come and do this, so we were able to reschedule and do our date in the Bronx at another time. So yes, to answer your question, I'm excited. And then more than that, I'm excited to get to meet you, Elder Johnson. I've heard a lot about your show, and I want to congratulate you on your effort. We're all in this together. And that's another thing that we have to understand, that there are no big eyes and little U's when it comes to the work of the Lord. It doesn't matter whether you're doing a local production or a national production, it still is going for the same purpose. And so I'm delighted that the Lord has anointed you and put you in this position also.
Yeah.
Bobby, one more favor for me. Would you look at that camera and tell our audiences, I'm Bobby Jones from the Gospel, from the Bobby Jones Gospel Hour, and that Jesus really is the answer.
Okay. I'm Bobby Jones from Bobby Jones Gospel, and I just want you to know today that Jesus really is the answer.
Most consistently visible face in black gospel music today, that is of Dr. Bobby Jones. He is host of the top-rated Bobby Jones Gospel Show, better known as Bobby Jones Gospel Hour, BET, televised on Channel 58 here in the Los Angeles area and many other areas as different channels. We want to welcome Bobby Jones. He is co-MC of the program tonight. Bobby, would you come and join us on the stage now? Would you join me in welcoming Bobby Jones from Bobby Jones' Gospel Hour?
All right.
Welcome.
Thank you.
You're welcome, Bobby.
It's good to be here.
It's a blessing to have you here. Thank you for joining us on our first anniversary cruise.
I'm delighted to be here. And hello, everybody.
Thank you, Bobby.
Bring your greetings from Nashville, Tennessee. They call that the Athens of the South. But I came in to bring up the traditional end of the service tonight. I'm the one that's going to listen to say hallelujah, say yeah. That's what we do down south. Say yeah.
Yeah.
Hey, hey, yeah. And I'm going to bring my homeboy back up. I'm so delighted that Linda and Reggie invited me to come over here tonight. We were down in Alabama on last evening. What a difference in the look from where I am tonight from last night, Linda.
If the ship of your life is tossing on the sea of strife, you need someone. And if you feel so all alone, and your house is not your home, you need someone. And now if it seems life isn't fair, and there's no one left to share all those lonely days and nights when things just don't turn out right, and you want someone to care, someone to just be there, you need someone. So I give you Jesus. The peace that passes all understanding, I give you Jesus. He has the perfect love which casteth out all my fear. Thirst again. So I give you Jesus, my friend. We give you Jesus.
And if the pressures that are all around are keeping your spirits to the ground, your health, the doctor said you can't regain. tell you that I know you need someone.
Come on.
And mothers, if you feel that you have tried with all the strength you had inside, it seems like you failed. Just remember on the cross he nailed all your bitterness and grief to give you that peace and sweet relief. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
That's all we got to offer you, amen? And that's everything, amen? No matter what you're going through.
It happens to be, the show is called Bobby Jones Gospel, and it's on the Black Entertainment Television Network. And it happens to be the number one show in the world for gospel music. And I'm delighted that Los Angeles has sent us, thank you, sister, has sent us so much talent to help us to serve the Lord. And I ran into a wonderful gentleman tonight by the name of Elder Johnson. And most of you know him. He has a great gospel show here. So, and I'm going to be on his show, and he's going to be on mine. And what you see tonight is what you're going to get on the Black Entertainment Television Network in about a month, because we are taping it, and we want to show everybody, all you wonderful people here in Los Angeles. Now, give that a big one, y'all. Yeah. Rosalind Graham has been down to do our show, and I'm glad to see you, Rosalind. Mr. Utley, I think you're going to help me with this one,
yes,
right?
Yes, please, yes.
Well, I guess everybody knows now that the field of Christian entertainment has really expanded itself tremendously. Not only do we get the expression through dance, through song, through the spoken word, but we also bring some humor into the business. There was a time, Reggie, when people used to go to church and just sit and look straight, not move, not say anything, extremely stoic. You remember those days, right?
Yes, I do. Yes, I do.
No more.
No more.
No more. We have some Christian comedians.
Praise God.
I had two of them on my show already, Jonathan Slocum and Lester Berry. Y'all know Jonathan?
Yeah.
Wonderful, wonderful comedian. And I hear tonight that there is someone else who does the same thing that we're going to get a chance to hear. Is this true?
Yes, it's definitely true, Bobby.
Well, tell me about it.
This young man is a very talented young man. He's, of course, has on the road a lot. He's one of our favorite people at K-Max Radio. He's our own K-Max impressionist, and he's been on our show several times. But he does 250 voices, different voices. He has a brand new album, a cassette that's called The Brain of a Mustard Seed.
I see.
And he is a very talented young man.
Uh-huh.
As I mentioned, 250 voices. He's an impressionist, comedian.
Yeah.
Let's bring him up.
Let's do that. You all ready?
Yeah.
Ready for a little laughter now, right? All right, let's hear it, ladies and gentlemen.
Christian comedian, ladies and gentlemen, Scott Wood.
Yes.
Give him a big hand.
Put down the mic. There you go, right
here. Use this one.
Give it up, Scott Wood, come on! Okay, can you guys hear me? Good, shut up. No, I'm just kidding. Anyway, it's good to be here. My name is Scott Wood, my friends call me Collect, and I am glad to be here tonight. And, all right, I know you did. He said, I caught it. But it's good to be here. Everyone looks good. The guys are decked out. Do they look good, ladies? Yeah? The women look sharp. I like the women because they look good. They got like, the hairstyles are jamming tonight. You know what I'm saying? I look around, I say, yeah, if you can't achieve it, weave it. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Girlfriend, you know. But, looks good, you know what I'm saying? Got that look that's happy, not nappy. I hear you, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. I got that same look, you know, extensions back here, you know? Come on. Anyway, I'm going through a trial, so you gotta bear with me tonight. Somebody stole my car stereo out of my car this morning, and they replaced it with an 8-track player. I couldn't believe it, you know what I'm saying? And Ronald Reagan is no longer president. Ronnie was cool. You ever notice Ronald Reagan looked like Gumby? Did you ever notice that? Ronald Reagan looked like, if it was dark outside, you saw a silhouette of Ronald Reagan and Gumby side by side. Okay, can you guys see this out there? Check this out, look. Ronald Reagan or Gumby, film at 11, okay? And how many people remember the original series Star Trek with Scotty, Spock, McCoy? My favorite character was Captain Kirk, William Shatner, because he was like the biggest overactor known to mankind. Right, it's like, William Shatner is Captain Kirk of the Starship Enterprise. Spock. Scotty, Mr. Scott. Beam me up, Scotty. I'm constipated. Scotty! My favorite space movie was Star Wars. Who saw Star Wars? Remember Star Wars? My favorite character from Star Wars was Darth Vader.
Skywalker. I've got asthma.
What's is happening? Anybody have parents they want to confess to tonight? Or perhaps you are a parent with children? Now, parents are weird. Parents always embarrass you, don't they? Like, my mom would embarrass me, you know, doing things. Like, one time she went to the refrigerator, got the milk out right, they smell it. And she turns to me, she says, "Ooh, Scott, this milk is sour. Here, try that." Remember that?
I know that you've enjoyed this broadcast, this special broadcast of Jesus is the Answer from off of the water and this anointed cruise of God. Amen. I know you enjoyed the entertainment. I know you enjoyed the encouragement. Amen. This is Elder Johnson. I just want to invite you to write us right now at Jesus is the Answer, Post Office Box 5651, Compton, California, 90224.
Just beg to differ with them, y'all. Just beg to differ. Okay? Come on, y'all. Put your hands together. They start making all fun and they say you're getting too emotional. Let's go over to them and say this, say.
Excuse me, my friend, I don't mean to offend. But when it comes to praising my God, I get excited. I don't mean to get loud, but I will shout out
in
my
New York minute.
Shout his praises for everywhere I go.
Listen,
just the other day, a question came my way.
This guy said, "Man, why you get so emotional about the Lord?"
He said, "To lose your composure, that's undignified exposure, and that's something that one cannot afford."
Well, I said,
"I don't mean to be crude, and certainly not rude, but there's something you really gotta understand. When I think of what he's done for me, the joy bubbles up inside of me. The tears get to roll in my hands, get to wave. If you think that I'm misbehaving, well,
excuse me, my friend.
Excuse me, my brother.
I don't mean to offend you. But when it comes to praising my God, I get excited.
The French brothers say, pardonnez-moi.
Pardonnez-moi, mon ami. I just got to make you see.
Listen.
See that God is good and worthy to be praised. He's worthy.
When we talk a little more as we walk from the store, I asked him, I said, man, how's your favorite team doing these days? He said, man, did you see the game? The boys are playing like they're insane. He said, I think we're gonna win it all this year. He said, look, I even got tickets to the game next week. I can't wait to get in my seat. I said, wait a minute, you're getting too excited. You're losing your composure. And if I turn on my TV to the game, you know what I'll see? You'll be there screaming and yelling, waving your hand, acting all wild up in the stands.
Excuse me, my friend.
Excuse me, brother.
I don't mean to praise
you.
Praise,
get up out of your seat.
Praise,
clapping your hands to the beat.
Praise,
come on and praise the Lord.
Praise,
get on one accord.
Praise,
he has brought you out.
Praise,
you've got something to shout about.
Praise,
praise the Lord, this is Bishop Ernest Johnson inviting you to come to a miracle move of God this Sunday morning at the Jesus is the Answer Apostolic Church. We're located at 25100 South Normandy Avenue in Harbor City, California. Come on out if you need healing, you need deliverance, you need to be saved, you need to be baptized in Jesus' name, filled with the Holy Ghost. I want to invite you to come on out to the Jesus is the Answer Apostolic Church, 25100 South Normandy Avenue in Harbor City, California. Join us this Sunday morning at 11 a.m. and Bible study is Tuesday at 7:30 p.m. Come on out and we'll see you there. Are you ready?
Yes.
Are you ready?
Yes.